Fighting over toilet paper. Let's have a look. Hello everyone, Florian Heiser here, and welcome to another episode of Heiser Says. I have my stein of coffee, and I thought we'd finish Sunday by having a look at this article from news.com.au that addresses the two women who were filmed fighting over toilet paper in a Sydney supermarket. Now, in many ways, I didn't know if I should look at this in a video because it's just disgusting and frankly pathetic behavior. People fighting over toilet paper. And it's probably just a sign of where our civilization is at. What would it be like in Australia if we were a few days without food? How do you think people will act and behave to each other? What steps do you think the government would take to maintain order? Would the government be able to maintain order? I wonder, what tribalism would develop and what divides would occur in our community? Who would people turn to for help? Be interesting to think about, isn't it? If people are fighting over toilet paper. So let's have a look at this, guys. I'm sure you've all seen the footage online. It's pathetic, really. Two Sydney women. Oh, and by the way, happy International Women's Day, everyone. Two Sydney women have been charged with a fray following a fight in a supermarket over toilet rolls. Video of the incident filmed yesterday in a Woolworths store in Chullora in Sydney's southwest was watched by hundreds of thousands of people after it was posted online. Staff were forced to intervene to break up the brawl. That's not what you expect when you have a job in a supermarket, guys, in a Woolies. Seriously. On Sunday morning, New South Wales police said they had charged two women following the altercation. A 49-year-old woman was allegedly assaulted in the incident. Police said she was uninjured. At about 8 p.m. on Saturday, two women attended Bankstown Police Station and spoke with investigators, police said in a statement. Two Bankstown women, aged 23 and 60, were issued court attendance notices for a fray. Both are due to appear at Bankstown Local Court on Tuesday the 28th of April 2020. I mean, they're fighting over toilet paper. Just dwell on that, guys. Just dwell on that. I mean, remember, we had the bushfires. What did Australians do who didn't have cash? They robbed grocery stores and petrol stations. What does that tell you about our society these days? What does that tell you? You know? People are so used to having instant access to everything that even the fear of going without something is such a simple thing is driving them to physically assault each other. Or if they're, you know, slightly desperate, can't go a few hours, a few days without some food, they're robbing shops. Yeah, great. Aussie. The incident was one of a number reported at Australian supermarkets as the desperation for toilet paper, which is not in short supply but is being purchased in far higher quantities, reached absurd levels. I mean, that's the thing. We're seeing here mob panic. This is the mob mentality. It's just self-fulfilling. It's like, you know, some ways like the tulip craze. People are just doing, they don't know why they're doing it. They're rushing and rushing to do it. Have you stocked up on your toilet paper, guys? Once you go off the standard Australian diet, or on, you know, become a carnivore, go to the carnivore diet, you don't need as much. Because you're not eating stuff that's full of rubbish, guys, which is all the fiber and stuff. That's a wake-up call, actually, when you watch some lectures by Dr. Paul Mason and realize what you can avoid. But that's for another video. If you're really desperate, you know, consider changing your diet, although it'll be a few hairy days before you get through. Anyway, the video shows one woman punching another at least once as a nearby crowd screams in astonishment. The fight occurred at 7 a.m. yesterday. Clutching grocery bags alongside a trolley loaded with toilet paper, the two women scream wildly as they throw punches and pull each other's hair. "I just want one pack," one screams, aggressively shaking and pointing her fingers. "No, not one pack," another replies as she begs with the woman to leave her daughter alone. Another, who attempts to calm the scuffle down, calmly says to one of the women, "Think about what you're doing." I somehow don't think Australians have the stoicism as, say, the British had when they were bombed. Keep calm and carry on in the Second War. Maybe that's just the difference in the generations now, perhaps. Do you think that could be what it is? I don't think people have the... Well, there isn't really the pride in being Australian anymore, is it? It's not really taught at schools that much. We're all shamed for it all the time, particularly if you're a white male. Lord forbid... You know, you dare take pride in your nation. They're not even teaching Western history at universities. I know at kindergarten it was all you know, Aboriginal or African history, nothing about European history. Perhaps that's what's leading to this. What happens if there was a disaster and they were calling upon people to enlist? How many Australians do you think would bother? How many men do you think would refuse? The way they're treated by some parts of our society. Crowds nearby can be heard telling the manager to call the police, while another asked what the recently enforced limit for purchasing toilet paper had become. So we're rationing toilet paper because of this insanity. During the week, the major supermarkets were forced to ration the sale of loo paper to keep the nation from running out as panic buying set in. But these efforts have been unsuccessful at fanning the anxiety of shoppers, culminating in the fight. Bankstown Police Area Command Deputy Officer, Acting Inspector, wow, they've got insane titles, Andrew New, said the supplies of toilet paper are constantly being replenished and there's no need to panic. So, which company should we buy in to take advantage of? I mean, toilet paper, of all things. Violence would not be tolerated. And anyone involved in this behavior may be committing an offense and find themselves in court, he said. Wouldn't that just be embarrassing if you went to court over fighting for shit paper? Commenting on the video shared online, a woman claiming to be an employee at the supermarket condemned the fight. "I know both customers as I work there. Jenna Gaham, I can't pronounce that road. It's ridiculous to think this is what we have come to." Yes, it is. It is. This is what our civilization is at now. People fighting in the aisles over toilet paper. And it hasn't even gotten bad yet. This is just a bit of mob hysteria over one item. What happens if food starts running out? What happens if people can't get their sugar fix? You know, their Nutri-Grain or their other rubbish they're eating. Supermarkets have struggled to control crowds all week as hysteria. And that's what it is. This is hysteria. Has swept the nation. Woolworths spokesman confirmed to news.com the fight was filmed in the Sydney suburb of Chulara. "We will not tolerate violence of any kind from our customers in our stores, and we are working with police who are investigating the matter," the company said. Well, maybe Woolworths and Coles needs to start putting security on for the toilet paper guards. Toilet paper. You know, it'd probably be cheaper. It'd be cheaper for people to buy and install a bidet than pay these insane prices for toilet paper. Just buy a bidet, get it installed. You could probably get it for a couple hundred bucks, $300-$400. Hell, it'd improve the value of your house. Everyone's watched Crocodile Dundee, at least the sequel. A Woolworths, yes. A makeshift sign spotted at Woolworths in Bendigo declares a zero tolerance towards violence. That's not going to stop it. Come on, bullshit that is. Anyway. Meanwhile, a news.com reader has spotted a man in Western Sydney, suburbs of Preston's, selling toilet paper on the side of the road. The entrepreneur had a trailer loaded with household items, selling one roll for $2, three roll for $5, or a box for $70. The market provides, guys. The market provides. Although I'd put good, that really looks like it's a stolen pallet of toilet paper, isn't it? Or he got it from a mate at the factory. Or maybe his dad is a you know, a, what do you call it, prepper, and he said, screw this, and install it. Canned foods, bleach, and other household essentials have been snatched up, but it's the empty shelves of toilet rolls that have captured the imagination of social media. There's quite a few things going on here, and it is therefore a fairly complex issue. Clinical psychologist Dr. Ross Knight told news.com.au. For whatever reason, there could be a few contributing factors. People are getting quite anxious about the global illness. Dr. Knight, who is also president of the Australian Psychological Society, said the bizarre reaction is likely the result of concerned consumers trying to take ownership of a seemingly helpless endemic. And she implored Australians to express their anxiety in a healthy way and instead focus on understanding the real dangers of the illness rather than the unnecessary hysteria. If you're hearing about an illness that's going to cause a pandemic and it's killing people all around the world, if you're hearing the hype rather than the facts, well, what do you expect from punters that punch each other up over toilet paper? Seriously. In reality, of course, it's not necessarily, or at least definitely not at this point. It's not an appropriate response to the level of threat we're currently under. A psychologist would know people aren't sensible. So what do you think, guys? What do you think? What do you think would happen if Australia went 3 days without food? Let me know your thoughts and opinions in the comments below, guys. Do you think our society would remain cohesive? Or would it disintegrate and fragment? What do you think? Let me know your thoughts and opinions in the comments below. Take care, and I will see you in the next video. If you're a fan and you want to support us, there are a few ways you can. Share the videos, share the content, help the channel grow. You can support us by joining the channel on Patreon or here on YouTube for a small monthly fee. We also have affiliate links for Amazon and eBay for your consumer purchases, and KuCoin Independent Reserve for your crypto trading. We sell merch made from the pocket squares, made from the, right here in this house from the Heiser Says website, and finally PayPal if you want to contribute that way. Thanks, everyone. Have a great day. And I'll see you next time. Bye for now.